Wracks are my personal favourite miniatures out of the entire Dark Eldar range. They're really creepy and really frightening, and they're also loads of fun to paint too. Now in this video, I'm going to show you how to paint one in the colour scheme of the Prophets of Flesh, which as you're going to see, is not at all hard to do. So, let's get started. The most prominent feature on a Wrack is of course his unhealthy pale skin, so I'm going to begin by painting that. And the technique I'm going to use is useful for all kinds of Dark Eldar, so this will work for anything in your Dark Eldar collection, and also for Dark Elves if you want to paint them as well. Now the first colour that you need is Wrackarth Flesh, and as always give these paints a good shake before you use them, and the brush you want to apply this with is a large brush. Now I'm going to be using my palette here, and it's always a good idea to use your palette, because this allows you to control firstly how much paint is on your brush, and it also means you can thin it down with a little bit of water, and you don't need very much. If you just mix that in there, this means that the paint will dry smoother and also apply a bit better as well. So once you've got your paint ready, you just need to start base coating this onto your Wrack. Now it's been undercoated with Chaos Black Spray, and all I'm going to do is start roughly painting this onto all the bits I want to be flesh. Now I don't have to be very neat at this stage, because I'm going to be neatening up as I go along anyway and add other colours onto him. But you may see that when you're putting this on, you can still see some of that black through, and I can just around there. That's absolutely fine, you're just going to let this layer dry, then apply a second one afterwards, because it's always better to apply multiple thin layers than one thick layer. That way you can avoid clogging any detail. Once you've finished the base coat, the next step is to apply a shade over all the flesh. And the colour I'm going to use for this is Writing Flesh Shade, and I'm going to be applying it using my same large brush. Now when you're applying this, you just need to make sure that you get enough on the flesh that it settles nicely in the details without running off the model. So the amount you're looking to apply to your miniature is kind of like what I'm getting here. So you see it's nicely defining all that texture and detail and muscles there. Now if you like experimenting a bit, it might be worth having a go trying this with some Drukhari Violet or even some Caraberg Crimson. Doing that can get you some really interesting effects, which is perfect for a creature that's experimented on as much as a Wrack. I've given the shade 20 or 30 minutes or so to dry, and once that's done, you're ready to start layering the flesh. Now the first colour you need for this is Wrackarth Flesh again, but this time I'm going to be applying it using a detail brush instead. Now when you get your paint ready on your palette, something you need to do is, once it's ready, just start twisting your brush as you drag it along your palette like that, and doing this will bring the bristles to a nice point, which will give you lots of control, which is really important for this stage. Now what you need to do is start painting on the raised areas of the muscle, following those kind of sinewy lines on it, just like that. This won't make too much of a difference just yet, but as I add more layers to the flesh, this will give a really nice texture on areas like that. Now as you're going around these parts, just avoid the recessed areas where the shade is collected earlier on, so in the middle of his chest like there, for example. All you've got to do then is work around all the flesh, picking out all these areas, and this will really brighten the skin up. Once the first layer is done, the next stage is to add a second layer, this time using Pallid Witch Flesh. I'm going to use this to build up a nice bit of texture on the muscle as we go. So you're going to need a fine detail brush for this, and just as before, use your palette to get your paint ready, but it's very important this time that you get that fine tip, because you do need that control for this stage. So when you're ready, what you're looking to do is apply the paint in much the same way as what you've just done, only this time, purposely let some of that Wrackarth Flesh show through. So I'm going to be painting lines following that sinew here, but I'm not painting all of it, as you can see. I'm letting some Wrackarth Flesh show through there. So you just need to take your time now, going around all of the body doing this, getting all of the skin. So now I've finished that second layer, and you can see what I mean about having that really nice texture and all those flatter areas of muscle. All that remains to do on the skin now is to just add a fine highlight to it. And for this, I'm going to be using White Scar, and I'm applying it once again using my fine detail brush. So as before, just use your palette to get that good tip on your brush, just like that. And well, there's not really many places you need to paint this. You're just looking for all the sharpest features. So around his neck around here, you've got kind of like this line of skin. So I'm going to put just a highlight running all the way around there. And also just beneath his pectoral muscles, just along the bottom there. And also I like to do the fingers and toes with this as well. But once this is done, all the flesh is complete. And with that last highlight done, the skin is now complete. Now I'm going to move on to painting two different areas. I'm going to be doing the armour and also his legs as well. And both of these areas require a solid base coat of black first of all. So I'm going to neaten up first using a Baden Black on any areas where I've gone over and painted flesh on these parts. So I'm using a standard brush for this, and this bit's, well, it's very simple this. You just need to pick out these parts that you want to be black and just get a good base coat over them, just like there. And when you get near to the flesh, just be careful so you don't get any of this colour on it. So now I've finished neatening up the black, and you can see I've done things like the van braces and around his waist as well. If you need a bit of guidance for this part as to which bits to do black, then just have a look at the box artwork and that will guide you through it. But once you've neatened up these areas, we're ready to start painting the armour. Now for this I'm going to be doing a technique called edge highlighting, and the first colour that you need is Eschen Grey. And this you need to apply using a fine detail brush, because, well, for this you just need to be as neat as you can. So get your paint ready, and use your palette to get that good tip on your brush. And what you're looking to do here is paint a thin line running around the edge of each armour panel. So down his front of his body here, if I just show you down the bottom, I'm looking to paint a thin line running along either side here, like that, and then one down the centre as well. And doing this kind of thing will really help define all those armour plates. So you need to go around the miniature now doing this on all of them. On the face, if you decide to do that green glow, which I'll be doing later on, you don't need to do around the eyes, just make sure you get that centre line running down the middle of his mask. Now I've finished the first highlight, you can see it is a bit subtle, but I'm going to add a second one now just to finish it off and really brighten it up. And for this you need Dawnstone. I'm going to be applying this using my fine detail brush again, but this time I'm just going to be a little bit more focused as to where exactly I put the paint. So once you've got it ready, this time you're looking at, well, if you imagine on your miniature light shining down towards the top of it, down that way, what you want to do is paint the edges where the light would catch. So that generally means paint the tops of these armour panels. So I'll be painting the top along there, for example, and on all these ridges running down here, but I wouldn't be doing the underside of them. So you just need to go around the model now doing this, and once that's done, all the black armour will be finished. Now I've finished that last highlight, you can see it's really helped define all those black armour plates. And of course, this technique's useful anytime you want to do black armour, such as on black Templars, for example. And now that that's done, the next thing I'm going to paint is his black legs, but this I want to have a slightly different feel to the black armour, so I'm going to use some different colours instead. First of all, I'm going to highlight with Skaven Black Dinge, and then I'm going to do another edge highlight using Carrick Stone. And if your rack happens to have an apron, then it's a good idea to do that part in the same kind of way. But I'm going to be using my fine detail brush, and the application is, well, the same as what we did on the armour, really. You just need to make sure that you get a good tip on your brush, and then you're looking to paint this along the edges or the most raised bits of detail. So on his legs, I'm looking at these creases down here. So just thin lines running on these bits all around the bottom of his legs around here. Then add a fine highlight of Carrick Stone. Now you really don't need very much of this, just a small amount on the very sharpest creases. So I'm just putting a small amount just on these parts down here and also on the front here where the black meets his toes. And with that highlight finished, all the black parts are now done. So now I'm going to move on to adding some other colours to the miniature. And I'm going to start out with his robe, for which you need Rhinox Hide. And this I'm going to be applying using a standard brush. Now for this step, it's all about getting just a good even base coat across all of the fabric. So once you've got your paint ready, you're looking at painting all these areas around here. Now on the racks, they all have different details on these parts, little bits hanging from the belt. Don't worry about those, we'll come back to those after the robe is done. So just a base coat and then we'll move on. So now I've finished base coating the robe, I'm ready to move on to the next step, which is going to be a little bit unusual. I'm actually going to base coat the silver next using Lead Belcher, and that's because both the silver parts and the robe all use the same shade later on. So if I do both those parts at the same time, then I save a bit of time, which is a really useful technique for when you're painting units and lots of miniatures at once. So I need a fine detail brush for doing this step, because the silver parts are quite detailed and there are quite a few of them. So I'm going to be doing things like the weapons and also the trim going around all the parts where the flesh meets the black, and there's lots of things like staples as well. I recommend you look closely at the box art to guide you through this part, because the silver parts do vary quite a bit from miniature to miniature. Just take your time and be as neat as you can. I've finished base coating the silver, and as you can see there's quite a lot of parts for it, so once you manage to get them all, the next stage is to apply a shade over the silver and the robe as well. Now for this I'm going to be using Norn Oil, and I have two brushes. I've got a detail brush for when I'm painting onto the silver parts, and I've got a standard for when I'm doing the robe. Now when you're doing this, especially on the silver, you just need to be as neat as you can. It's especially important around these parts when the silver is connected to the skin. On these parts, just be careful that when you apply this that you don't put on too much, so that the shade settles on either side of the silver, but doesn't run out of control onto that flesh. So just take your time with this stage, and when we're done, we'll move on to highlighting. With the shade dry, we're now ready to start highlighting these areas. And I'm going to begin by highlighting the robe, and for this, the first colour you need is Doomball Brown. And I'm going to apply this using my fine detail brush. Now this is going to be another edge highlight, just like we were doing before. So Once you've got your paint ready, you're just looking to paint a thin line of this all the way around the robe. Now, because the detail on these parts is quite pronounced, what you can do is use the side of your brush rather than the tip. So if I run the side of my brush along there, you see I can very quickly and very easily get a very neat straight line. So you just need to do this all the way around the robes now, and as you're going, just keep an eye out for any larger creases. There's one on the front here, just down there, so be sure to paint a thin line along that, just to pick that out as well. I finished the first highlight on the robe now, and I'm just going to do one more just to finish it off. So for this, the colour to use is Karak Stone, and I'm going to be using my fine detail brush again. And this time I'm just, going to be a bit more picky about where exactly I paint it. So once you've got your paint ready, this time you're looking for, well, the very sharpest of edges on this. So I'm going to be doing this colour down towards these corners on the front here, and just up to about there should be fine. And as I start going around here, I'm going to leave all the parts where the robe dip in, and then I'm going to start painting it again as it comes back out again. So just round here, for example. And with that last edge highlight done on the robes, that part is now finished. And now I can complete the silver as well. Now for this, you need Runefang steel, and this is going to be another edge highlight, still with the fine detail brush. Although at this part, some of the areas are, well, they're so small, you're going to be painting almost all of them, really. Once you've got your paint ready, the small parts I mean are things like these little metal components in his body, and like the staples and things. For this, you just need a thin silver line, just running round them, and well, that's all they need to be highlighted. Now, some parts are larger, things like his weapons, so for this, you can use the edge of your brush, just like when we were doing the robes earlier, just to go around the edge to get some neat straight lines. Once you've done this, all the silver will be finished. With that silver highlight done, you can see it's made a massive difference to all those parts. They're really jumping out now. And also, I've just painted a few details around the rack's waist. In this case, I've done a little leather cord and a little pouch down there. And those parts I painted in exactly the same way as I did his legs earlier on. And now with those bits done, we can move on to painting the bone. Now for this, you're going to need three colours. First of all, I'm going to base coat using Zandri dust. Then I'm going to layer over the area using Karak Stone. And finally, I'm going to add a highlight using Screaming Skull. So for the base coat, I'm going to be using a standard brush here. So I'm just going to get my Zandri dust ready. And, well, as with all the other base coats we've been applying, you're just looking to get as even a coat as you can here. And, well, you might find you need to do more than one coat. So just work along as you go. You'll find if you need to. But as you're around the back here, just be careful around where the spine meets his skin. Just be as neat as you can, because it can be a little bit complex around these areas. So just take your time. And once this layer's done, we can start brightening it up. Once you've finished the Zandri dust, and it took me two coats to get this even coat here, the next stage is to go to Karak Stone and use your detail brush to paint this on, but only onto the raised areas of this bone, leaving the Zandri dust showing in the recessed parts. And the final part of the bone is to use a fine detail brush to apply some Screaming Skull, just as thin lines on all the most raised parts of the spines, so just on the top of things like all these ridges down here. And there we go, now the bone is complete. Now I'm going to move on showing you how to paint the bright green vials, and these are a very distinctive feature in all the homunculi units in a Dark Eldar army, so painting these in the same way across all your models will really bind a collection together. Now the layout varies quite a lot from miniature to miniature for these green parts, but regardless of whether you're doing a pipe or a vial, you need to start out by using Caliban Green, and I'm applying this using a detail brush. So this step is all about just, well, once again, getting a smooth base coat. So on all of your pipes and vials, just as neatly as you can, completely paint them with this colour on all the glass. Now I've finished the base colour, I'm ready to add the first layer. And for this, you're going to need Warpstone Glow, and I'm going to be applying this in exactly the same way as what I've just done. So I need to make sure I've got the paint ready, still using my detail brush. Now, Warpstone Glow is quite a thin colour, so you probably are going to need to apply more than one coat of it. But because we've already got that Caliban Green down first of all, it means we're going to get a rich colour very quickly doing this. So there you see, it's going on nicely. I'm just going to apply one layer and let it dry and then apply another. So you see with that layer, I've got a good strong green. So the next thing to do is to add some highlights to this. Now I'm going to be doing two different colours for this. First of all, I'm going to do a highlight of Moot Green. Then I'm going to do a very fine highlight with Uriel Yellow. And I'm going to be using a fine detail brush for both these stages. And it's important here that you use your palette to get a really nice tip on your brush. So thin your paint with a small amount of water to help it flow easier. And just twist your brush to get that good tip. And what you're looking to do on these vials that have metal lids to them is to just paint a thin line of this colour just towards the top of them, just before it meets the metal. So just running along there, like that. Now on the vials that don't have lids, instead just paint a thin line just around the edge where the glass curves just towards the end there. And then add just a very small amount of urial yellow just towards the top of the vial. So just a little bit there. And well, once you've done this, the vials are finished. And if you want, you could add some art coat over them for a nice glassy shine. I've added some art coat onto those glass vials, and with that, those are done. And there's really not very much left to do on the model. It's just a green glow coming out of his mask. Now for this, you need two colours. I'm first going to be edge highlighting using Warpstone Glow, then I'm going to do a finer edge highlight using Moot Green. And, well, both of these I'll be using my fine detail brush again, and the technique is the same really as when we're doing the armour. So it's all about getting a good tip on your brush first of all, making sure you don't have too much paint, and then as neatly as possible, painting a thin line running around the edge of the hole in the mask. And of course, depending on which mask you've picked, this will be a slightly different shape. And then finally, just add a very small amount of Moot Green just towards the middle of the mask, just around about there. And well, once you've done this, all that remains is to base your miniature. And once you've done that, your model is complete. So there we go. Now I've based my Wrack and he is complete. And well, I'm really happy with how he's come out. Now, when you're painting Dark Eldar Wracks, remember it's easiest if you start out by painting the skin, because then you can be quite messy with that part. You'll neaten up as you go along and add other colours. Now, when you are adding all these other parts, be as neat as you possibly can. There were some quite precise techniques I used when painting this miniature, such as edge highlighting, and you can make life easy for yourself if you thin your paints with a little bit of water and make sure that you don't have too much paint on the brush. Now, if you've enjoyed painting your Dark Eldar, then there's a book you might want to check out called Raiders of Camorra, which will give you loads of advice on painting other miniatures in the range. But, well, I've really enjoyed painting this Wrack, and I'm sure you'll enjoy painting yours too. So, I'll see you next time.